down yonder and visit Victoria. See if she's changed her mind and tell me what she says.
My slave's done gotten himself into a pickle.
That may be true, sir.
Now, pretty lady, you know I've taken a liking to you, but honestly, do you love my brother?
Yes, sir.
Have you fornicated?
You're crazy.
I'm concerned you done got intimate with him.
Well, I never.
I despise him. Don't be friendly with him.
Don't you worry your little head. Your brother and Victoria are here.
I'd rather die before I let my darn tootin' brother come in between me and my gal.
Oh, God bless my soul. It's a travesty. My sister-in-law, she just is terribly evil. And the Union has invaded all of our lands, and we are in grave danger. And Clement and his daughter are on their side.
Good speech.
Why are we talking about this? We need to unite against them enemies of ours. Our problems ain't this issue.
Let's talk about that later.
I'll see you over yonder at the cabin.
Gordon, are you coming?
No, sir.
Start off, Tommy. It's a smart thing to do. Come on.
I know them tricks. Okay, I'll come.
You don't mind speaking to a poor man, please listen up.
Oh, I don't mind at all.
Well, open this here letter. She went in, making noise similar, and I fight to defend what I say.
Alrighty, I got to go. God bless your soul.
I see the enemy get ready to fight.
I'll be ready.
One.
I've done pledged myself to both these men. They're like snakes, they're so jealous. I don't know who to choose. Gordon would go mad if I stayed with Robert, but it's so hard to be with Gordon while his wife's still alive. I'll just use Victoria's power for now to win me the fight, and after that, one of the brothers can kill her. Victoria wants Clement and Luann alive, but if I have it my way, they won't be.
Come here, Daddy. I'm gonna lay up against this big old tree right here, okay? Right here. Hey, push me up, Daddy. I'm gonna go fighting.
Good luck.
Come on, Daddy, we gotta go. Can't go in, don't make
that. I can't. And this is a good spot to die.
That's silly talk. Come on, let's get up. You can't choose them back.
Ain't that the truth?
Come on, Daddy. Come on, Daddy. Got it. This way. Come on, keep going.
Take him away and guard him good.
We ain't the first ones to be here. I'm worried about you, man. I might want to contact my brothers.
No, we can live here. We can live in jail singing and praying and gossiping.
Take him away.
We could be like foxes if they try to separate us.
Come on, move it.
Get over here, Phil. Take this letter and follow these instructions and follow them to prison. Do as you're told and don't be a wuss.
Yes, ma'am.
Do what you're told, then.
If it's work for a man, then I'll do it.
She'd be a problem if you two be away.
You never know what may come true.
Whoa. Don't go imagining things, brother.
Well, if I didn't feel so sick while I gave you a piece of my damn mind, you're now my master. I surrender everything to you.
Whoa. Are you trying to get into her pants?
Yes or no, it's not your decision to make.
It's not your decision either.
Yes, it is, you bitch.
Prove yourself to me by beating any challenger.
Hush and listen. Meredith, you are under arrest, along with your snake and rascal of a husband. And brother-in-law. If you want to get married, you're going to have to move a little on me, because my husband is already betrothed to Meredith.
We got a situation here.
Meredith, you have a weapon. If nobody else is going to apprehend you, I will.
I feel sickly.
If he ain't sickly, I ain't never gonna trust drugs again.
I'll fight anyone who thinks I'm a traitor.
You're on.
I feel sicklier and sicklier.
Somebody, take him inside. He's feeling sick.
I'll fight anyone who steps forward.
You're on.
I ain't got no name anymore. I'm just because she is.
Who's that?
Who speaks for Meredith?
I speak for myself.
Well, draw your weapon. Here's mine. I know you're a traitor. I'm gonna kill you.
Regardless of my southern hospitality, I'll fight you anyway.
Oh! Saver! You've been tricked into fighting, Meredith. You ain't truly lost. You've been tricked.
Shut up, you awful man!
don't you tear it up. You just knows what it says.
And what if I do? I make the rules around these parts. You can't judge me for it.
How awful. Did you know what it says?
Mind your own business.
Follow him. Make sure you don't do something stupid.
I've done it all and more. You'll learn soon enough. What is your name? I may forgive you.
My name's Jim Bob. I'm your old man's son. Lord, it's fair. Just forgive each other.
That's mighty, mighty true. It's done come full circle, and here I is.
Let us be friends again. I never hated you.
I know.
And now, where's you done been? How'd you know about your old daddy?
I disguised myself as a beggar. I was in the dogs like me. I met my daddy on his journey. I was disguised for a while. I revealed myself to him not too long ago. His old heart just couldn't take it.
That's a mighty touching tale there, sir. Please continue.
Stop right there, Red. It's just too darn sad.
Before I continue the story, it would be a much worse story. But a strange man came up to us and told us a tale about him and Clemont back in the day.
Who was that man?
It was Keith. He's still friends with Clemont even though he treated him like a low-down rascal.
Help!
What's wrong, sir?
Spit it out!
He's dead.
What's wrong?
Who's dead?
Your husband poisoned my brother. He's admitted his guilt.
I was courting them both. Now we'll be together in death.
Oh, Keith's coming.
Bring the bodies from down yonder.
I came to pay respects to my master. Where is he at?
Oh, Lord of me, we just forgot about Colonel Clemont in the land.
Why is it this way?
Still, I was loved. One of the brothers poisoned the other for me and then killed himself.
True that.
Go save Clemont and Luann. I gave orders for them to be killed.
Run!
Oh, give us something to prove the order.
Take this here sword.
You dirty rotten scoundrel, she's hung.
Is this the end?
Or just a piece of it?
Oh, Clemont.
Go away!
This is your friend Keith.
Who's Keith?
It's me, Keith, your servant. I was also your servant Carl.
Carl's dead. He's long in the ground now.
No, it was me and no one else, and your brothers done destroyed themselves.
That's probably true.
Ain't no use talking about it. I'm giving Clemont all my power for the rest of his days. And I'm giving you new honors and titles.
Friends will be rewarded and enemies shall be punished. Oh, I will see you hang. True world, why do enemies live when she must die? Oh.
He's not blacked out.
Oh, my poor eggy heart. Don't disturb him. Let him go to the place on up high.
He's really gone.
He lived on borrowed time for a while there.
I suppose we should get some warning now. Looks like you two have been left in charge of the Confederation.
My heart, I can't go on much longer.
Man, we should remember this day. If the old ones hurt the most, we should say what we feel. We won't live as long as he did or see what he saw.
Go.
I see the enemy. Get ready to fight.
I'm gonna go to church and then I'll give a sweet tea. I'll be back in like 5 seconds.
No.
What?
Clemont, put that down there and sat.
Go.
Oh, you. It's a smart thing to do.
I'd rather die than let my darn tootin' brother come in between me and my gal. My sweet sister-in-law is evil. And the dog dying union has invaded our land. And Clemont and his daughter, they're on
their... Whoa. Are you trying to get into her pants?
Is my hair better, or is it still sexy?
Don't get to a fit and listen.
John!
Shelly, be sure. I can't thought of it.
John!
And listen.
I'm dead in the ground now.
He's done dead in the ground now.
No, it was me. No one else. Your eldest sons have destroyed themselves.
Ouch!
One.
Whoa. Are you trying to get into her pants?
It's not your decision to say yes or no.
That's not your decision either.
Yes, it is, you bitch!
Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Holy crap! I tried to, guys.
I came to pay respects to my master. Where's he at?
Lord of me, we done forgot about Colonel Fleming and the Lion!
Really, look.
Oh, sorry, you're sorry, Mom.
You've been tricking.
Aw, brother. Hush and listen. Meredith, you are under arrest, and your snake and rascal of a husband is under arrest, too. Now, brother-in-law, you...
I'd rather die before I let my darn tootin' brother come in between me and my gal.
This is a travesty. My sweet sister-in-law has just turned completely evil. And oh my goodness, the Union Army has just invaded us. Our lands are in danger.
I can't do it. We can go for their parts and then we can come in.
John,
you're still running, I can't.
All I am is the bones you made for me, so garishly clean, white as the horses.